everybody, I have a couple drills for you to help strengthen your shoulders and your core to help you have a better push-up. So we're working on perfecting your push-up today. We're going to start with basic what a plank is. So a plank is holding that high push-up position, working on keeping your body in pretty much a straight line. So as we plank, we want wrists under our shoulders, legs straight back. And we want to make sure that we are in control of our hips, so we're not letting them, our hips dump forward and sag our low back towards the ground. We're keeping our hips rolled backward, belly button in towards our spine. We're also giving the ground a little bit of a push, so we're not collapsing in our shoulders. We're being nice and strong through that shoulder joint, and keeping your head looking slightly ahead of you, so your neck is in line with the rest of your spine. So now that we have a good plank, we're going to build off of that, because most of what a push-up requires is a lot of upper body strength, and that comes from having a stable shoulder joint. So we're going to start with doing a scapular push-up, which is moving your shoulder blades, so retracting them and protracting them from this plank position. So setting our plank, and then by only moving from your shoulder blades, we're going to work on squeezing our shoulder blades together and pushing into the ground to round our back a little bit. So squeezing and pushing. All while being aware of the low back. So as you squeeze, don't let your hips come down. Only moving the shoulders. Our next plank variation.
How many repetitions should someone do?
Rolling through these, you can do about 10 of each. If you can't make it to 10, try to do 5, give yourself a little rest, do another 5, and slowly from there you can build yourself up as your strength gets better. So next we're gonna work on doing a plank, transitioning into a down dog. That takes a lot of stability out of, from the shoulder, and we're working on changing positions with it. So being stable in multiple positions and angles. So starting in our good plank. And once we're here, we'll hold it for a couple seconds. And then shift our hips back and up towards the ceiling, keeping our shoulders nice and strong. So I am actively pushing with my hands into the ground as I stretch out my hamstrings. Hold it for a couple seconds and then shift yourself forward. Pause and then shift. Working on pulling the shoulder blades back away from your ears and keeping the crease of your elbow facing forward as much as you can. And the last exercise would be holding a plank and doing shoulder taps. So working on a little bit of dynamic stability and maintaining weight through one arm at a time. So we will assume our plank position. You can keep your feet a little wider for this one for the weight shift, but you'll just nice and slow tap your shoulder across, trying to limit how much side to side sway you have, keeping your shoulders and hips facing the ground. So I said previously, we want to try to go up to 10 for each of these, and then, you know, work them into your normal warm-up routine for your conditioning to improve your push-ups.